El Tajín was discovered in 1785 and had a massive population at one time. We know this in part from the architecture, in part from the sheer number of ball courts that we see, upwards of 17. But the piece we're looking at is actually just to the left, the Pyramid of the Niches. Now, the Pyramid of the Niches is only about 60 feet tall, with evidence of multiple reconstructions, something that we've seen over and over in Mesoamerica, that idea of building a rubble core and then a shell around it, and then continuing to do that one on top of the other until you get the present form that we have today. Now, in this case, we see six levels with 365 niches reflecting the solar calendar. And you would think, well, this has everything to do with sculpture, this has everything to do with a calendar, but it kind of goes a little bit deeper and it has nothing to do with sculpture. It's a very Western idea to put sculptures in niches. Actually, it's an Italian Renaissance idea. But here, they wouldn't have had sculpture. Instead, those niches represent caves. The caves are representative of the underworld and the afterlife. So it's an artificial cave system, almost an artificial entry into the afterlife. So what we see here is the Mesoamerican connection between astronomy and time. More importantly, the beginnings of their understanding of space and time, things that they connect at a very early stage. The idea that space and time must be connected. Now, we're not getting into Einstein and ideas of general relativity and such, but they have this conception that the two must be related. We also see a connection here between the afterlife and time. Obviously, you don't put representations of 365 caves in without 365 being a particularly important number. So the afterlife and time and space all being tied together in one place is really going to be important. Now, the problem we run into is, of course, we're in classic Veracruz, where we have little context and almost no history. We don't even know who these people were. So for me to say absolutely that this means X, Y, and Z would be particularly difficult. Again, that context, all the history behind this piece has been stripped away. We only have the physical elements in front of us. Whereas with many other cultures, we have elements of writing, we have other elements of history, but here we have none. It's kind of like when we look at the prehistoric world, we run into the same issue. Except that this is far more complex than what you tend to see in, for example, the Neolithic.